Today I'll be presenting about my research project, which was a retrospective cohort study exploring the association between neighbourhood level social capital and the incidence of psychosis in Stockholm, Sweden. Social capital captures those elements of a community's networks which support the attainment of common goals. Most believe it's an ecological construct, which can either operate horizontally, where bonding represents in-group closeness and bridging represents connectivity between groups, or vertically, through linking, which captures community influence and access to resources from higher power institutions. These types of social capital can be measured cognitively by capturing a community's attitudes and values like trust, or structurally by capturing a community's behaviours and institutions. It's theorised that social capital buffers the effect of negative life events through social support, self-esteem, and access to helpful institutions. Also, that trust in community participation promotes healthy cognitive and emotional development and is beneficial to mental health. A relatively strong relationship has been established in line with this theory for cognitive bonding social capital and common mental disorders. However, most of the evidence so far is cross-sectional, uses screening measures to identify mostly common mental disorders, and has been limited in capturing the breadth of social capital. Very few studies have explored psychosis or cognitive linking social capital. Some studies have even indicated differential effects of social capital, where outsider groups like migrants or ethnic minorities may actually fare worse in high social capital areas due to being excluded from in-group bonds. So it might be wrong to assume that we really understand how social capital relates to mental health. So, my study sought to address these gaps by being large-scale, longitudinal, well-defined, and extending the research base to psychosis. I sought to explore whether low neighbourhood social capital led to greater incidence of psychosis over time, and whether there are differential effects for migrants. I utilised the Swedish National Registers and a retrospective cohort design to identify incidence of clinically diagnosed non-affective and affective psychotic disorders in Stockholm between 2002 and 2016. 1,527,097 people met inclusion criteria and were analysed in group level data organised by SAMS neighbourhoods, where each stratum represented a group of people with shared characteristics in the same SAMS. The responses of 15,591 people to the 2002 Stockholm Public Health cohort were aggregated to each person's SAMS neighbourhood to provide a neighbourhood level score for social capital. This included cognitive scores of political and welfare trust, representing linking social capital, and personal trust, representing bonding social capital. I conducted multi-level Poisson regression analyses for the primary analyses, and then added an interaction term to explore relationships with migrant status and region of origin with social capital. Overall, neighbourhoods with greater bonding social capital had lower incidence of both non-affective and affective psychotic disorders. Linking social capital did not contribute to the final models, and deprivation was important in reducing part of the relationship between low personal trust and high incidence. These findings did not change significantly in sensitivity analyses, which removed social capital raters who later became cases, or when removing neighbourhoods with less than 5 social capital raters. Also, a weak interaction was found for bonding social capital and migrant status, where children of migrants were less protected against psychosis in highly bonded neighbourhoods. A strong interaction was also found for bonding social capital and region of origin for non-affective psychosis only, where people of African and Middle Eastern origin actually had an increased risk of non-affective psychosis if they lived in highly bonded neighbourhoods versus Swedish, European or mixed persons who remained protected. This opposite effect was similar for Asians and other people of other backgrounds. So, a longitudinal relationship between bonding social capital and incidence psychosis was confirmed, supporting existing common mental disorder literature. This wasn't true for linking social capital, however. To understand our findings, we have to compare sample differences, where our social capital raters were more often female, Swedish European, and older than the population at risk was. Providing support to cross-sectional findings of difference, it appears that bondedness of the ethnic majority group may actually result in greater exclusion and worse mental health in the younger non-European outgroups. For linking social capital, the ratings we used were not adequately representative of the population at risk. So, this project highlighted that we must not assume social capital to be a benefit to all, and instead highlighted the importance of socio-political context and intergroup relations in understanding how social capital functions.